In the previous video, you had a quick tour of the Smoke user interface just to familiarize yourself with the basic layout. Let's rewind to the very beginning and start Smoke for the first time so you can go through the process of project and user creation. The first window you will encounter after starting Smoke is the Project and User Settings window. Under the Project section, click New to create a new project. This will bring up the new project settings. The first thing to do is click in the text box and give your project a name. This name has to be unique from the other projects on your system. Remember to press Enter to confirm any typing that you have done. The project settings define the default resolution that your project is working at. One thing I would like to point out is that you can easily mix resolutions and frame rates, but the project settings give Smoke a starting point if you know the resolution setting of your final deliverable. But don't worry, most things can be adjusted during your session. Let's continue. For example, I will choose to create a project at 1920 by 1080, and I will set the color bit depth to 10-bit. The last two options are for graphics processing. The options are defaulted to use the GPU of your graphics card and process all operations at 16-bit float point. You shouldn't have to change these options in most cases. Next up is the configuration template. This simply refers to the running frame rate of the project, as well as the output to your broadcast screen. So for example, since this project is 1920 by 1080, I will use an HD profile and set the appropriate frame rate for my edit and source material. Now, other aspects of setting up a project is to tell Smoke what your intermediate format is going to be. This refers to all the project-generated media, such as renders and local copies, which are stored in this format. You have a selection of formats to choose from, including uncompressed. In this instance, I am going to choose ProRes 422 as my format. Obviously, you should choose the compression format that your storage can handle. Finally, one last option you have before committing to a new project is proxy creation. This option is off by default. When enabled, Smoke will create smaller versions of your media, enabling you to work faster in certain circumstances. Please be aware that this does eat up your disk space, as well as increase processing time as new media is generated. So you've set your project up, and clicking the Create button will create a new project into the Smoke database. It is now accessible from the Project pop-up button. To create a new user is pretty simple. Under the User section, click the New button. All you need to do is enter your name and press Enter. You can also choose from a variety of keyboard shortcut profiles. Choose the Smoke profile, as these are the keyboard shortcuts that I'll be mentioning throughout the course of this video series. Click Create. So now you have a user and a project, and you can press the Start button. A final word on projects and users. You can switch projects and users through the Preferences menu at any time without having to restart Autodesk Smoke. Remember, the project settings refer to the default resolution settings for the project, and your user keeps track of your bookmarks as well as your keyboard shortcut assignments. In the next video, we dive right into the Media Hub and start importing footage into Smoke.